Welcome back to Learning with Friends with Miss Sue. So glad to see everyone today. Hello, Holly. Hello, Nathan. Hello, Cash. I'm glad that you are here. Hello, Christos. Hello, Jada. Hello, Layla. I'm glad that you're my friends. Today we're going to talk about the letter Y. Why, oh, why are we talking about the letter Y? Getting to the end of the alphabet. One more after this. I have a sheet on our website, www.cureforthekids.org, under our Education Center and Learning with Friends, where you can practice making the letter Y. What are some things you can think of that start with the letter Y? Y makes a yuh, yuh, yuh sound. There's not a whole lot. But I brought some things that are yellow, because yellow starts with the letter Y. How about something that we eat? Do you like to eat yogurt? I like frozen yogurt. I like regular yogurt too. Blueberry's my favorite flavor. Can you think of anything else that starts with the letter Y? How about if I talk really loud, I'm yelling? Yelling starts with the letter Y. I have a sheet on our website that has some pictures of some other things. This is a yak. It's an animal we don't really see very much in the United States. It lives a lot in China and that continent, but it looks kind of like a cow with really long hair. This is a yam. A yam is kind of like an orange potato. I like to eat yams, especially at Thanksgiving. Yarn. Sometimes our clothes, like sweaters or blankets, can be made out of yarn. This is a yo-yo. It's a little thing on a string that you make go up and down. It's kind of hard to do. And this is a special boat called a yacht. It's very, very fancy. So there's some other things that start with the letter Y. I wonder if you can think of any more. I have a book for us today called Cancer Party. I didn't know cancer could have a party. I wonder what they're talking about. Did you know that every living thing is made up of tiny little guys called cells? Trees are made of cells, people are made of cells, cats and elephants and carrots are all made of cells. Cells are like little blocks, but they put themselves together, right? We are cells and we are so tiny you can't even see us, but we are what bodies are made of. We've talked about cells before, haven't we? One very cool thing about cells is that one cell can make another cell any times it wants. I'm lonely. And look what it's doing. It's splitting into two. Yay! That means that cells can build and build and build. It's like building with Lego and never running out of blocks. Imagine the tower you could build with Legos if you never ran out. Every cell has a job. Together they build body parts, then tell them how to work. They make hearts pump, legs walk, and lungs breathe. We are blood cells, and we are heart cells, and we are skin cells. Hey, thanks, guys. Without them, our bodies wouldn't work at all. And having a healthy body is basically the best thing ever. A healthy body can run, jump, swim, and play. But every once in a while, one of the cells forgets what its job is. I can't remember what to do. I'm so confused. Look at that guy. And since it doesn't know what else to do, it decides to have a party. It's really lonely at the party because all the other cells are working. A party with just one guy is kind of boring. But remember, it knows how to make friends, so it does. It splits itself in half and makes a friend, and then that cell makes a friend, and that cell makes a friend, and before long it's a big party, a cancer party. There's just one problem. A cancer party isn't healthy for a body. No one at the party is doing a job. Soon the party gets so big it starts to crowd out the guys that are doing their jobs. And that's no good. We need all our cells to do their jobs so our bodies work right. When someone finds a cancer party in their body, they definitely want to get it out. We want our bodies to stay healthy and work perfectly. So how do we get a cancer party out? To get the party out, usually a doctor can give someone surgery. This means the doctors will make the person go to sleep at the hospital, then carefully take the party out with a tiny knife. The person doesn't feel anything. Once the party is out of the body, the other cells in the body are happy. Every single cancer cell is gone, and they can make the body work right. Woohoo, they say. Doctors need to get all the cancer cells out of the body, and sometimes surgery isn't enough, especially if the cancer cells packed up their pals and traveled to other parts of the body, or if the cancer cells are swimming around in a person's blood instead of hanging out in one spot. If that happens, doctors can do two things. Sometimes the doctors use a big machine to zap the cancer cells with a heat ray called radiation, and they all die.
It looks like the party's over.
To get radiation, the person lies on a table with a big machine that sends out the rays. They usually have to go to radiation every day for a month. Radiation doesn't hurt, but after a while, the person's skin might get red like a sunburn. They might also get tired. Both of those things go away quickly. The doctors can also give the person medicine called chemo, and the medicine kills the cancer cells. When cancer cells die, the party is wrecked, and the cells have space to do their job again. The medicine kills the cancer party, but it also does some very not fun things. One thing the medicine does is kind of weird and maybe funny and also sad. It can make the person's hair fall out so they are totally bald. It also makes the person feel tired or sick for a long time. They can't run, jump, or play like they used to. On some days, the medicine doesn't bother the person so much. You can take a walk together, drive places together, read together, or watch movies. But other days, the person's body might hurt or feel tired. On those days, ask the person how they can help. They might need a hug, or they might just need to sleep. Unfortunately, there's nothing you can do to make cancer go away. You didn't start the party. That's impossible. And you can't end it either. But you can make a person with cancer feel happier, and that is a very important job. And all the hard stuff is worth it when the cancer party is gone. All the cells are doing their jobs and the body is healthy again. Yay, we have room to work again. And you know what that means? A healthy body that can run, jump, swim, and play again. And new hair. Woohoo! That's kind of a cool book. We've talked about cells before, haven't we? And how the healthy cells have important jobs and those cancer cells just get in the way. So I never thought about describing it like a cancer party before. But that was kind of a different way to learn about it, wasn't it? We'll be back in just a few minutes, okay? Hi everybody, welcome back to Learning with Friends. We've been talking about all kinds of different animals. Today we're going to talk about jungle animals. What kind of animals do you think live in a jungle? I've got some sheets on our website that have some pictures you can draw of jungle animals. Elephants are jungle animals. Lions and tigers are jungle animals. And zebras are jungle animals. I wonder what some of these animals eat. What do you think elephants eat? Have you ever seen movies of elephants? They use their trunks to grab things and put it into their mouth. They like to eat leaves and grass and hay and things like that, don't they? Sometimes we see movies about elephants eating peanuts, but I don't know if elephants really do eat peanuts or not. I think elephants like watermelons. I've gone to the zoo and seen them have watermelons. I bet that's a tasty treat for elephants, don't you? Some elephants can give us a ride. They're such strong animals and they're so big that some people ride on elephants. I like watching elephants fill their trunk up with water and squirting it like a hose. They can give themselves their own shower, can't they? That's pretty cool. Have you ever visited a zoo and seen an elephant? They also can use their trunk to make sounds, can't they? It sounds sort of like a trumpet. I don't make very good elephant sounds, do I? So elephants are a jungle animal. What about lions and tigers? They're kind of ferocious animals in the jungle, aren't they? They are meat eaters, so they stalk prey. Prey are animals that they eat, like gazelles and impalas and things like that. Lions make a family called a pride. Lions and tigers, their babies are both called cubs, aren't they? Have you ever watched the movie The Lion King? It talks about the lion is the king of the jungle, and they have a pride of lions. It's kind of cool. Boy lions have this big furry mane around their face, and girl lions don't have that. Tigers have beautiful stripes on them, don't they? And they're very sleek and fast. But I don't think I'd want to meet a tiger. They have very sharp teeth, don't they? And I have a zebra. A zebra kind of looks like a horse that has black and white stripes on it, doesn't it? You know, there's a joke about what's black and white and red all over? A zebra with a sunburn. That's kind of a silly idea, isn't it? Zebras make kind of a funny sound. They don't neigh like horses. It's almost like a laugh. And zebras, I guess, are not very nice animals. Sometimes they can nip at you. I've seen zebras at the zoo before. They're not quite as big as horses. What do you think zebras eat? They eat food similar to horses, like grass and hay. What other animals do you think might live in a forest? If it's a rainforest, they might be snakes and alligators. Monkeys live in the forest, don't they? They swing around through the trees. They eat berries and fruits and bananas. Things that they can find high up off the ground. Monkeys are very fast, aren't they? And they have very strong fingers and tails that help them swing on their branches. Can you think of any other animals you might find in a forest or a jungle? Lots of different ones that don't live in Las Vegas, right? So that's our animals for today. I'm going to bring Jamie over for a second to say hi to everybody. Oh, Jamie's losing her pants again. What are we going to do with this girl, huh? So, Jamie, some of the kids at the clinic this week were having a hard time getting their ports accessed again. And do you know that one of the kids helped another kid? I think it's really important sometimes when you see somebody else who has a hard time with something, huh? Do you remember what we saw? She showed her friend that when she gets her port accessed, she does that special magical breathing and blowing. And did that help her when somebody else who also had a port told her that? Yeah, it did help. I met a new friend this week who was a little boy who called his port his Iron Man button. I thought that was a great name for a port bump. An Iron Man button. What do you think of that, Jamie? Did you like that name? It is kind of powerful and magical, like Iron Man's button is, isn't it? Because that's where you can get all your medicines that make the cancer go away, and you can get your blood tests so you don't have to get pokes in your arms, huh? What's the best thing, do you think, Jamie, about having a port? I can take a shower and a bath, and I can go swimming with my port. Yes, you can do all those things. Is there anything else you like about having a port? I like Emla so I don't feel the pinchy part of the needle. Good. Emla cream is good for ports, isn't it? How about anything else you can think of that you like about having a port? I don't know. Sometimes I don't even remember that it's there when I'm at home. Well, that's kind of a good thing to not remember that it's there, huh? Yeah, well, good. Well, it's been really fun to spend some time with our friends, but our time together is over. We have to do a song, right? So let's do a song with some jungle animals. How about five little monkeys jumping on a bed? Those monkeys aren't in a jungle, and there aren't beds in the jungle, but we can do it anyway, all right? Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Four little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped her head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Three little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Two little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped her head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. One little monkey jumping on the bed. He fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Goodbye, Jada. Goodbye, Aria. Goodbye, Leona. I'm glad that you were here. Goodbye, Isaac. Goodbye, Jordan. Goodbye, Leonardo. I'm glad that we are friends.